3 for 33, Morning Stopper by PJT Rail. And it's PJT Rail, PJT 1974, and it's the Class 33 on the Great Western Mainline. Good morning, driver. You'll be driving the semi-fast service to Reading. Your first job is to pick up the coaches in Oxford up carriage 1. Your route should already be set. I'm going to check. So we're kind of pull forwards and go to up carriage 1. Right rear, that one. The loco brake was on. Now we can move. Right. Try and make a bit of an effort to make some sensible times. Cheers, Gouger. Thanks for joining this evening. It's morning now. So we're going to get our coaches in Oxford up carriage 1. Goes that HST. Roman, I think it is about 12:43, yep. Right, you may now switch cabs. Oops, put the brakes on. Not set to move yet. Alright, pick up passengers from Oxford 1. So we've now got to run into Oxford 1, and there is already a train there, so presumably we're going to get a red light somewhere down here. Yep. Proceed into platform 1 when the express service has left. Ignore the two shunt signals, but obey the two aspect signal. Okay. Moggy says, Victoria sponge cake would be better if the cream was ice cream. Ha. Oh, ha. Oh, you are awesome, dude. I think it said to obey the two aspect, which makes sense. The train is still sitting in the platform. Green light. Change the background. Well, the best I can do is the 66. Right, coming into Oxford, platform one. Interesting alarm. Got a few seconds to get stopped correctly, so we'll pull up a bit closer for everybody, make them have to walk a little bit less. PTG Rail wants cake. How do I feel? I didn't get any cake for my birthday. This is a crime. Right. If cream was ice cream, wouldn't it be Arctic Roll? Oh, Arctic Roll. That's awesome. Have I not got a background for each loco, Morik? No, I don't. Much as I would like, I don't have. Who supplied the sounds for 33? I've got no idea. It was actually done before I joined the company, I think. Is there a key on the key to key on the keyboard to couple the wagons without using the HUD? Yes. Control Shift C. Lights. This loco doesn't have lights, White Mead. It's got a. If you look at the at this, that lights up. So if I turn the lights off, lights on, and I switch it to the rear, you get that. So it's that that gets lit up. There really are no lights on the front of this loco. Right, Didcot Parkway. Do I get my backgrounds off DTG? No, they're just screenshots I take out of the game. Right. Bit of thrash to get out of there on time. Limit. Miles. Cheers, JPT. Thanks for joining. Oh, it's loud in there. Green light. I'm trying to catch up with this one in front at the moment. Oh, got something interesting going on up here. Couple of growlers. Did go partway, 8 miles. As long as your dreams aren't haunted by the Castle Douglas dispatcher. No, I laugh at him afterwards. Moggy, yep, there's a Mark 1 and Mark 2 mixture in there. It's not that uncommon, to be honest. I think it's the, what's at the front? Yeah, it's a first class Mark 1. And then, oh, hello. And then we've got a couple of, that's a right oddball mixture, isn't it? But it's not unusual. It's not unusual. Right, we're starting to get the head of the timing now. 6.7 miles to go, and we're starting to eke our way back and to the get the timing back on where it needs to be. PGT wants to link SimSync to TS to do the signals. Yeah, no. Then Fringe Darling would want to go. And that would be insane. Almost onto on schedule. Three miles to go. We're actually ahead of schedule now, just about. Limit coming up. I really do abuse this button, don't I? 1.1 miles to cut partway. Coming into what did cut Parkway 4, 40 limit. Starling, was this route built without custom assets? Well, no, it contains assets that Mobile 1M builds their routes from, so... Well, where'd that 25 come from? It contains assets that, everybody else builds there. So this is one of the original routes. Yellow light, so we're okay in. That's our home signal into Didcot. Right, stopping the train. We're only about 10 seconds late, I can live with that. Frisco. Driving a small K4 commuter train and got 75 to 90, went round a corner and the train went off. Cheers, Moggy. Thanks for staying on. Oh, there it is over there, look. Thrashing through. Distracting me. I've got to get going. We have a single yellow. Green lights. Mr. Nola 6930, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. No, this loco doesn't have front lights. It's not uncommon for the older British locos not to have front lights. Jory Seambell, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Jono Bossatronio, yes, it is my birthday. Well, it was yesterday anyway, given that it's after midnight now. 4 miles to Cholsey. Thank you. I saw the HST in the glimpse. Hey John of Ostranio, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Double yellow. It wasn't anything to do with night service. I mean, the thing is, headlights are no use to a train whatsoever. Because even if I could, a headlight cannot show me anything far enough in advance I could do anything about it. So lights are about the other people being out to see you, not you being out to see them. Cheers, DK Designerin. And the lit up head code, which is much more visible at night, is good enough for doing that. Right, throttling down. Looks like we've still got a yellow coming up. Yeah. Miles to the red. That's actually the home signal into Cholsey. I'm just coasting at the moment. Looks like a red light. That light's mine. I can't tell. Nope, we've got a red light. Loving the AI. Oh, got a yellow light. Cholsey. Alright, coming into Cholsey now. PTGRL, if you're going to do a route learning video on Donner Pass, you should do it all at once in one video, 6 hours long. Right, it's come to a stop. On time. BDG said that would be an absolute pain driving that far with no HUD. Yeah, absolutely. Just driving that far. Doesn't matter if the HUD is there, it would still be a pain. Are you liking the timing? So far, PJT, they are absolutely spot on. Off we go. Loving the AI as well. Goring and Stretley, 3.6 miles. Up to 50. Running a bit behind schedule now. I'm not sure how that happened. PTA is now going down rather quickly. Or it was. Then he stopped, just as I noticed he said something about it. Two point 3 miles. One point 5 miles to Goring and Stretley. Got a yellow light coming up. Went green just at the last minute. Forty seconds to get into Goring and Stretley. Streetly, however. Oh, light 37. Right, pair of light 37s. People in the last coach can just make do. Lots of HSTs. How are we doing? Pangbourne, Tilehurst and Reading. Pangbourne, 3 miles. Right, how was this light green? Good. Slowly getting the ETA brought back. So GSK says, I'm not good at, I must get the 33 now. I'm telling the boss it's Matt and PJT's fault. Fair enough. Fair enough. Green light out here. The home signal will be at least a yellow then. So we're okay into Pangbourne. Coming into Pangbourne, due in a bit under a minute. Second now, in fact. Oh, I'm typing into the chat. Just T. If you guys are having problems, it's not on my end. It's streaming beautifully clean on my end, so that sounds like Twitch might be having an issue with your side of things. Right, let's get rocking. Tilehurst, 2.8 miles. I think we just passed a yellow light, didn't we? DRA on this train. See if I can get advanced sight on that signal. It's a yellow. A green light. I was looking at the red on the other line. Right, on our way to Tilehurst. Due in at 2037, it's 1953. Car insurance advert isn't very productive. Right, passenger stop. Goodbye, GWR. Thanks for joining. Reading, which I think is our final station. It is. Thanks, GWR, much appreciated. Oh, it was a green light we were at last. It's always around a corner where you can't see it. Green light, go. Typing on the chat, not watching what I'm doing. That's a double yellow, so less panic than I had originally anticipated. I thought that was a single yellow. That means it's the home signal into Reading that's red. Frisco, that sounds reasonable. Got yellow light, so we're clear into Reading Platform 9. Alright, we're all in. It's time to stop the train. Alright, doors open. That was fantastic. I really enjoyed that. Did we get ticks? We got ticks. That was 3 for 33 Morning Stopper by PJT 1974. And that was, yeah, PJT 1974. Superb! Right, we've got one more scenario to run. Just wait for this timing to finish. had to be done. Thank you, driver. You are most welcome. Right, big thumbs up on that one. That was 3 for 33 morning stopper. Right, we've got one more to do, and then our epic, probably 6-hour germ stream. That's insane. 6 hours streaming. I'm completely insane, apparently.